Hello and welcome to the fourth episode of the Free to Be podcast. And today I'd like to talk about experience and understanding our experiences from a personal perspective, and how, for me, that's been what has liberated me to feel able to live life as myself completely. And so I've said this before, that we are free by nature. We don't have to ever do anything to become free. But understanding this for ourselves can help us in feeling able to live life as that freedom. Understanding that we are liberated in nature and seeing that for ourselves can really help us to let go of any ideas or beliefs that we might have that we are unable to respond to life in a way that feels good to us as individuals. And so conditioning can play out in so many different ways throughout our lives. It can affect the way that we engage with each other in relationships. It can affect the way that we treat ourselves as individuals. It can influence the way that we take care of our needs in life and give ourselves the things that we need to feel well and whole and at peace. And so once I started to learn for myself that the conditioning that I experienced within my mind wasn't as solid as I thought it was, once I realised that the conditioning that I had in mind wasn't the dictator that I thought it was, I felt more able to express myself from a quiet, gentle place within. I felt able to start feeling into my intuitive nature, feeling into what my senses were telling me about what was happening around me and about how I wanted to respond to it. I stopped listening to the voice of conditioning, the voice that told me that there was a specific way that I had to express myself, or that there was a specific way that I had to deal with a situation or with an individual based on any factor about them. I stopped listening to the conditioning that I had to treat myself a certain way because of anything about me. And as I looked deeper into this space and place that is present within myself, I noticed that there was nothing there. There was just this emptiness. And then an energy that has a desire to just express itself. And once I understood that I could allow my expression to come from that quiet, gentle place, I felt more at ease with life being what it is. I felt like less of a victim of my circumstances. I used to feel anxious and afraid about having interactions with people or with people asking me to do anything because I didn't feel like I was able to respond in ways that I would have liked to. And so I would just avoid situations, or I would lie and agree to do things, but then find excuses to not have to do them, and panic and stress and get myself into situations that I didn't want to be in because I didn't understand that I had an ability to respond in whatever way felt good. I felt like I had to respond in a way that the conditioning within my mind was telling me to respond. And once I learned, and it came from play, really, I just started to play with trying out responding in a way that I wanted to, and seeing if the responses that I got back from life were the horrendous, dreadful fears that were projected within my mind if I followed through on taking the action that I wanted to take in any given situation. And through play and curiosity and experimentation and trying things out, I saw for myself that life was a lot kinder, a lot more forgiving, and a lot more accepting than I'd ever given it credit for in the past. And life is actually pretty good and pretty easy when I felt able to be honest about what was happening in my experience, what was happening within myself, and how I truly felt and what I truly wanted. Not only did I realise that life was actually very kind and accepting and forgiving, I also found a place where I felt able to be the expression of it. I found the reflection of the life I saw around me, within me. I'd felt like a dark spot in life for a lot of my life as I was growing up, and I didn't recognize that there was a light within me. I saw life and I saw the light of life existing around me, but I never felt or saw it within myself, except for in odd moments where I would have experiences and realizations within myself where I felt the life that I was, but they were fleeting, and the rest of the time my attention was focused on thoughts and avoiding life. I think because I didn't recognize the life inside me, the life around me felt really intimidating. And once I started to get to know and understand and see for myself that the life within me was no different to the life existing around me, I started to realize the natural freedom that I've got to respond to life in a way that feels good. I started to see for myself that there was no part of my experience that was ever off limits or unable to be explored or observed or recognized. And I started to realize how wonderful life was once I saw it as a reflection of myself and I saw myself as a reflection of it or an expression of it, is probably more appropriate of a word to use. And so in essence, even though I understand now that I've always been free, that I've always been alive, and that I've always been an expression of life, there was a long time where I didn't grasp that within myself. And so exploring the mind, exploring my mind, coming to understand myself from a personal perspective has had some really wonderful benefits and a really wonderful impact on how I feel about life, how I experience life, and how I express the life that I am as well. And so that's all I want to share with you for today. So I hope that you've enjoyed listening to this fourth episode of the Free to Be podcast. I hope that you come and join me again. But for now, take amazing care of yourself. Lots of love, and I'll see you soon. Bye.